Start with a prayer. Father God, we just thank you for tonight, Lord. Thank you for your presence here, even before we've come, Lord. Even though as we've been preparing, Lord, and we've been doing things throughout the day, Lord, you've been preparing our hearts ready for tonight. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for that where two or more are gathered together in your name, there you are in the midst, Lord. So we invite you, Lord, just to have your way tonight, Lord God. Speak through me, speak through your word, through the songs that we're going to sing, Lord. May everyone that comes here and is listening, Lord God, be blessed and be encouraged and be renewed in their faith for you. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Here I am. best friend that we could ever find, Lord. Thank you.
at the center of it all. Jesus at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus. Jesus, everybody's in Jesus at the center.
Jesus, we've been through. team?
Following?
Yeah. So, thank you again to Tita Ina for allowing us to be held in her house here. There's a beautiful grand piano there. Maybe I'll play that next time, as well as a guitar. What I wanted to talk about briefly is just how God is our ever-present help in time of need. We all have needs, we all have things in life that we have been struggling with. I know Titina's got a need that we'll pray for a bit later, and if anyone else has any needs, we'll also pray for them as well. So. Good to have you here. So I want to ask a question. Where do you go when you need help? Who do you turn to when you are down? In Psalm 121, verses 1 to 2, it says this. It's, I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. We have a God that created heaven and earth. He should be the one that we go to. We should lift up our eyes out of our problems and look to the Lord, for he is our helper, our deliverer. In Psalm 46, verse 1, it also says, God is our refuge and strength, an ever-present help in trouble or in the time of need. So you may be going through something, but God is your refuge. As well as looking up to him, we need to run to him. In these times of social media, with memes and vines, emojis, stickers and GIFs and all the smiley faces, where are we getting our counsel from? Lately, I've had a lot of memes and things appear on my wall, and I've shared them, and I even created a couple myself. And they're often just very short messages, just a short inspirational quote. And we all love our quotes and affirmations. And usually I share something that means something to me, something that I'm going through presently, or something that I've been through, or something that someone I know is going through to help them. I love sharing encouraging words and the worship song videos, which I do pretty much every day. Share via SMS, Facebook and YouTube. And a couple of people here I send them to, and I pray they're a blessing to them as well. And I'll have to point people to God, because God is our help in time of need. We can't rely on ourselves. We can't always rely on friends. Gloria and I have a very close friendship, and she mentors me in my weight loss and fitness and things like that. But I can't always run to Gloria as a friend. Though I know she'll be there as much as you can, but she's married, she's got her own family, she lives far away. But she's a blessing to me, and I hope I am to her as well. God uses these memes and things that we use to encourage each other. They can convey a truth, but to tell you the truth, we can't base our life decisions upon a meme, upon a quote, or upon an affirmation. Because you can find an affirmation or a quote to back up whatever you want to say. Am I right? It could be good or bad, whatever. And there are many memes and funny vines on there which express ideas that I don't think would want our kids to follow in life, or we wouldn't want to follow ourselves. But I find that the more, more I share these memes on Facebook, the more they appear from different sources in my newsfeed. The Facebook algorithms detect my viewing habits and my interests. So instead of seeing things which are detrimental or distractions, I get to see lots of different quotes and memes, and I like to unshare them, like to share them to other people as well. Often though, these memes, I share them or other people share them, and they get hundreds of likes. It's incredible how much a simple quote or a simple phrase, sentence can speak into someone's life just at the right time. And I praise God for that. I praise God that the right thing can really build someone up and encourage someone. Sometimes the videos that get shared on Facebook, inspirational videos, they may not get that many likes. We live in a 20-second generation. Our attention span has really reduced with social media, with SMS and our phones, constantly checking to see if we've got any update message, or we could be in the middle of something and we get messages from different places around the world. You are some people from the Philippines, so you get messages at 2 o'clock in the morning because it's 11 o'clock at night there. It's a wonderful way of keeping in touch, but our attention span has really reduced. And we struggle sometimes to find that time to spend with God, to pray, to read the Bible, for those very same reasons. We live in a generation that can't seem to concentrate for long periods of time. I know I'm guilty of it. I find it affecting me too. As I can rarely watch a long video. Someone sends me a long video, or a long video appears on Facebook, then I might watch maybe a minute of it if I'm really dedicated, but then unless it really grabs my attention, then I'll just go on to the next thing. We get like an adrenaline rush from the next thing that appears in our news feed, the next bit of information. And you see this in the chain letters that get sent around Facebook. Recently, one appeared again in my news feed and my messenger about a girl being burned alive for her faith in India. And I remember seeing that a couple of years ago, but sometimes it's shared like it's recent and people don't really check the background. But we're so keen, and we can get on our soapbox for a particular cause or a particular thing that we see, and we don't really check the facts. We need obviously to be very sure before we forward something on. And that's why sometimes a meme or a... Does anyone know what when I say meme, it is basically just a quote or a short affirmation, something to encourage us. When we see that, we can share it, because it speaks to us, and we know it may speak to someone else. I do like to listen to long sermons, or messages from a good speaker. On YouTube and even on Facebook, sometimes you see a really good speaker, not just a Christian speaker, could be a motivational speaker, someone that really gives good wisdom and can share good wisdom. And it's really worth the effort then to listen, to spend the time and listen to those people that can encourage us and bless us. But the question really remains, who is the one that you can really help us in our time of need to fill the void? The loneliness. Sometimes I find myself just checking Facebook and I don't get anyone messaging me, and I go, what's up, what's happening? Aren't people concerned? You know, you get that adrenaline rush in you. And sometimes you're up late at night and you're just wishing for a message, someone to message you, someone to encourage you or just make you feel like you're of value. But are we turning to that instead of turning to God? Our value, our worth really needs to be in God. Well, sometimes we may turn to our friends. Oh, we all had those people that get really upset and they just lash out or react on Facebook. And you see... You know their life story, you know their suffering, and they're craving attention. But are we turning to that? Are we turning to our Facebook friends, who are really often just acquaintances, instead of turning to our loving Saviour, the one that can really help us in our time of need? We need to be turning to God first, in prayer and His Word and the Holy Spirit for a counsel. They need the Holy Spirit. Jesus promised to send the Holy Spirit, that He would be our counselor, our comforter. He is there for us. He is the ever-present help in time of need. Prayer is the most important conversation of your day. I got sent this as a meme, and I love this. I just sent this. Got an incoming call. Joseph downstairs. I don't know if you can see that. Can you read that? Prayer is the most important conversation of your day. Take it to God before you take it to anyone else. That, for me, is a really wonderful reminder of what we need to do before we go talking and running to our friends or running to Facebook to get help or feel comfort. We need to take it to God first. It's nothing wrong with having friends that can help us, and God will bring those people into our life to help us. But we've got to take it to God first. He's always there to listen and comfort us, to give us wisdom and help us. He's like a loving Father. Do we know Him as our Father? Do we feel His embrace? Do we hear His voice speaking to us, encouraging us? Sometimes we feel distant from God, but God is as close as that prayer. The prayer is a hotline to heaven. God's never far from us. In Psalm 34, yeah, I encourage you to read that psalm when you get home. I've just selected certain verses out of that, and it's just so encouraging. This is King David saying, "This poor man called, and the Lord heard him. He saved him out of his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear Him, and He delivers them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in Him. The eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and His ears are attentive to their cry. The righteous cry out, and the Lord hears, and He delivers them from all of their troubles. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. The righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers him from them all." That's in Psalm 34. I encourage you to read that. It's a wonderful psalm, encouraging psalm. So I want to encourage you, don't look within. So many times we hear people say, and a New Age philosophy says, just look inside yourself. In the song, I think, Whitney? Look inside you, and I can't remember all the words. But what's inside us? If what's inside us was sufficient, there would have been no need for Jesus to die on the cross. In Jeremiah 17:9, verse 9, the Bible encourages us. It says, well, the heart of man is deceitful above all things. But he doesn't leave it there. In Psalm 37, it says, Proverbs 4, verse 5 to 6, and it's one that you'll know. It says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all of your ways, submit or acknowledge Him, and He will make your path straight." And Psalm 37 continues in that same vein. It says, "Take delight in the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your ways to the Lord, trust in Him, and He will do this." So if we had enough, if we were sufficient in ourselves, in our intellect, our understanding, as I said before, there would have been no need for Jesus to die on the cross. So don't look either to yourself or to anyone or anything else. Because we're in danger of giving that place that only God deserves, that only God is worthy of, to someone or some created thing. And it may be a friend, but it may be turning to Facebook, it may be turning to people, turn to lots of different things, drinking, smoking. Also, they may just turn to just wanting to be with people because of they don't want to face the loneliness that they're really struggling with inside. One of the Ten Commandments, it says, you shall have no other gods before. So I want to encourage you, whatever you're going through, whatever you're facing, struggles, turn it over to God. I'll leave you with this from Philippians 4. It says, rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from the Bible or seen in the Bible, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for your encouragement, Lord, tonight, that we need to go to you first, Lord. I thank you for all the good and wonderful people and the wonderful quotes and memes that come across my path, Lord, which encourage me and I've been able to share with others, Lord. But Lord, we need to go to you first. Forgive us, Lord, for putting people or things before you, for giving them the place that only you deserve. Jesus, we thank you for dying on the cross. We thank you that you loved us with an everlasting love. You loved us before we even knew about you. You loved us first. That's why we can love you. So we ask you again, Lord, tonight, to come and be the center of our lives, to come and take your throne in our lives. We love you, Jesus. We enthrone you. And we just cast all our burdens, our anxieties, our worries upon you, knowing that you are in control, that you are God, and we are your people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let's sing that again. Jesus at the center.
Nothing in this world will do.
center of your church. Very much. We praise God for His presence here tonight. We thank you for coming.